year 2014. 2014. thank the Lord. How I wish we could just continue praising and worshiping Him. Because that is His food. And we continue to praise and worship Him. Situations change. It's not in the amount of what we say. But when we praise Him, things will turn around. Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank the Lord for all those testimonies. Powerful testimonies. Testimonies that indeed you are not in the wrong place. Tell your neighbor you are not in the wrong place. You are in the house of God, where God Himself comes down to bless His people. God doesn't send His angels to wonder when He Himself is present even with us here. I want you to just shout hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, briefly want to look at a topic that talks about the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. It is a very powerful statement which was made by David. Amen. And that statement alone has several implications. There are several sermons that you can bring out from this. In fact, it can take us a whole day to analyze that statement. But by the special grace of God today, we just want to look at two implications of that statement which David made when he said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." Praise the Lord. What is the implication of that statement? My point number one is that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, is a testimony of victory over lack. It is a testimony of victory over lack. That is why I am decreeing into the life of somebody today, you will not lack again in the name of Jesus. Everything God lack will be a stranger in your life in the name of Jesus. Everything God lack will be a permanent stranger to you in the name of Jesus. And I say in the mighty name of Jesus, because God Almighty is your shepherd, He will provide for you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The God will not deny you of victory in your life in the name of Jesus. The God will not deny you of joy in your life in the name of Jesus. The God will not deny you of favor in your life in the name of Jesus. The God will not deny you of promotion and success in the mighty name of Jesus. Because He is your Lord and He is your shepherd, you shall not want in the name of Jesus. Praise ye the Lord. And so, that David made several years ago, as he declared it, I can imagine where he declared it. He must have told a congregation, must have told a people, that as for me, this is my testimony. I have already put lack behind me, because there is a mighty God that is with me. There is a mighty God that is manifesting Himself in my life. That was David's testimony. And what is our own testimony today? I started asking myself, what is in a testimony? What is in a testimony? And then the Lord directed me to Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, when He talked about overcomers. He said something about overcomers here. He said they overcame Him by what? By the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimonies. Amen. Meaning that your testimony is complete as you begin to tell people about whom this God whom we serve. And that is why I celebrate those who came out to celebrate the Lord, the good things that the Lord is doing in their lives. You are the next one to testify of His greatness in the name of Jesus. I said you are the next one to testify of His greatness in the mighty name of Jesus. Whether you like it or not, God will arise on your behalf and He will give you a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. He will testify of His power in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I still look deeper and I said, what is in this issue of testimonies? And I find out that when you are testifying about this Almighty God, there is one thing that you are doing. You are showing up Jesus to the world. And when you begin to show up Jesus to the world, Jesus has no choice, but He will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus. This is what I meant when I was in the June Holy Ghost service. I went for the June Holy Ghost service. And I had a statement from a preacher during the course of that Holy Ghost service. He mentioned, he said, when you decide in your life to show up Jesus by testifying about Him, God in His mercy will have no other choice than to show up in your situation. I don't know what situation you are in today. As you make up your mind to show what God Almighty, the Maker, the one who brought you to this earth, the one who made you, showing up, he will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus. And again, I was told also that when you decide to tell your challenge about the God whom you serve, rather than telling God about your problem, God himself will begin to arise. God is going to arise on behalf of somebody today. Maybe you don't understand, when you are telling sickness, that sickness, you don't even know the body in whom you are dwelling in. You are dwelling in the temple of the Holy Spirit. You are dwelling in this body which God has created, the Almighty God. When you begin to tell sickness, rather than telling Father, heal me of this sickness, miracles begin to happen in the mighty name of Jesus. And I will show you evidences of this, even in the scriptures. May the Lord arise on our behalf in Jesus' name. May the Lord arise on our behalf in the mighty name of Jesus. And so I tell you today, your miracle is at hand. Whether the enemy likes it or not, you are a victor, because you are the overcomer in the mighty name of Jesus. So the statement, the Lord is my shepherd, is a testimony. And as I said, once you decide to show up Jesus, like coming out to testify of his goodness, God himself will show up for you. How do I know this? When you study the encounter of David and Goliath, one of the secrets of David's victory over Goliath was the fact that David made Goliath to know that the God whom he served is bigger, is mightier than he is. Praise the Lord. David took him through a lecture about the God whom he serves. And at the end, what happened? David was victorious. Just as somebody else will be victorious over his challenge, over that giant, that Goliath that is facing you today, as he began to speak to that Goliath. When he tell that Goliath that you are served, that you are serving the Almighty God. When he tell that Goliath that there is a king that is bigger and higher than any other king. When you are telling that Goliath that your challenge is nothing compared to this God who is able to do far beyond our expectations, those situations begin to move in Jesus' name. That's what David, when we read 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 45 to 47, he took Goliath through a simple lecture about the God whom he serves. And at the end of the day, Goliath's head was on the floor. Every enemy in your home, every enemy concerning you, because you are going to speak to that Goliath and not run away from that Goliath today, his head will hold on the floor in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ. And so, David, in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 45, then said David to the Philistines, "You come to me with a sword and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts." The Lord of hosts will show for you in the name of Jesus. The Lord of hosts is behind you. And he will come and show forth for you in Jesus' name. Amen. So David told him, "Who do you think you are, Goliath? You come with all these things. You don't know the God that I serve. Oh my God, how I wish you knew the God that I serve. You would not have dared to come before me today. You would not have dared to challenge me today. But I will tell you a little bit about this God." And he went on and went on. He says, "But I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. You come against the armies of the Most High God, and you think you will be a victor? You must be a joker." That's what was told Goliath. And I can imagine that Goliath's head would have been beaming and fuming, and you can imagine everything going on. And he again told him to annoy me more, because you will annoy your enemies more today in Jesus' name. You will annoy them to the extent that they will get so angry and mad with themselves, and they begin to kill themselves in the name of Jesus. My hands, and I will smite thee and take thy head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the hosts of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God." That's what he said, there is a God. There is a God. There is a God. must fear, for the battle is the Lord's. Brethren, your battle is the Lord's battle. Amen. Your battle is the Lord's battle. Amen. You don't need to fret. You don't need to worry. All you need to do is rest in his arms. And he says he will give you into our hands. Praise the Lord. For God Almighty himself will fight on our behalf in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That was all David needed to do. And God did it specially for David. You know, the story was that even as David, as Goliath was approaching him, God in his mercy came down in his power, stationed Goliath's head, such that as the stone was coming, he had no choice, but the stone came straight for his forehead. That would be the portion of your enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. God held his head down, so that he could meet the stone. And that would be the end of all your enemies, even today, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Why do I know that when I testify, I am showing up Jesus and he will show for me? I want to recall in the book of Acts chapter 16, verse 25 to 30, when we read the account, we read the account of Paul and Silas when they were in prison. They were held bondage in prison and they did nothing other than to praise and worship his God. They chose to tell the problem about the God whom they serve, and that's why they decided to praise and worship him. That's why I'm so delighted, as in this place, the Almighty God has taught us how to praise and worship him. We are not gone there yet, but we are getting higher in the mighty name of Jesus. That's why testimonies will not cease in this fellowship in the name of Jesus. Whether the enemy likes it or not, testimonies cannot cease, because we are giving God what he wants, and that is praise and worship. We are telling our situations that there is a God that is bigger than that situation. That will continue to be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. And what does the Bible say in verse 26? At midnight, when they had been held in bondage, several floors inside the prison, God says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas pray, and they sang praises unto the Most High God. And the prisoners had them, and we knew what happened. Praise ye the Lord.
Yes.
And there was another statement that which I had on that June Holy Ghost service, which said, when the supernatural comes into the natural, because the natural cannot contain the supernatural, an earthquake happens immediately. That's why I know that that's your situation. God Almighty will send an earthquake to root it out in the name of Jesus. That is confronting you today, that stops allowing you to place a smile on your face. God Almighty, who is the God of the supernatural, will supernaturally uplift it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so, because the natural cannot contain the supernatural, the gates were too small to contain the Almighty God. The gates have no choice but to give way. Praise ye the Lord. And that's what will happen concerning you today in the mighty name of Jesus. As they began to praise and worship him, that's what the Bible tells us. Paul and Silas began to worship him, their testimonies came. So shall be your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. We had another encounter in 1 Kings chapter 18, where we saw Elijah. He was confronted with a situation where the people had decided in their hearts to go after other gods, despite what God had shown them. I pray this will be your own situation in the mighty name of Jesus. But after God has blessed you mightily, you will choose to go after other gods. After God has shown you the way, you will choose to go after other gods. That will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. And anyone that wants to take you away from the focus of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord Almighty will separate you between them in the mighty name of Jesus. And so we are told in that 1 Kings chapter 18 that Elijah was confronted with a situation where the children of God were at crossroads. They were at crossroads to decide whether they wanted to serve the Almighty God or they were going to serve the prophets of Baal. And he didn't bother to argue with them. He didn't bother to fight with them. He just said, okay, if this is the choice you want to make, I'm going to show you something today. And he went ahead and said, come, you prophets of Baal, let us enter into an encounter. Let me come and tell you the God whom you serve. Let me come and tell you the God who is behind me. Let me come and tell you the God who is the Lord of heavens and the earth. Let me come and tell you about the God who created all things and was never created. Let me tell you about that God who existed before the beginning. I was not the beginning, but existed even before the very beginning. That was what he said. And he called them out by contents. And we know what happened even in the course of the contents. The prophets of Baal continued to cry out unto their own God. They shouted, they made a lot of noise, asking that their God would come down. The God that they his life in the mighty name of Jesus. And so Elijah was faced with this situation. And instead, he didn't even bother. And just tell them, let's continue. Just continue calling on your God. Your God will surely answer. Maybe he has gone on a journey. I'm sure he will answer. Just keep calling on him. And the prophets kept on calling. They kept on calling. They were beating their heads on the road, on the road. They were hitting their hands on the road. They were shouting. There's so many things were done in that encounter. But it got to a point. Elijah now had to tell them, okay, it could be that your God is sleeping. Please wake him up. But you are serving a God who never sleeps. And you will never sleep in your situation in Jesus' name. Because he is watching over you daily, every single second of your life. God Almighty is watching over you because you are dear to him. And he told us, prophets of God, continue calling this God. Maybe he has gone somewhere, he has gone on a journey. The God Almighty can never go on any journey concerning you in Jesus' name. God is our ever present God. He is always with you, and he will always be with you in Jesus' name. But the most important thing is that you must have a relationship with him. If you don't have a relationship with him, he cannot be with you. That is the truth about it. You don't have a relationship with him, you are left into the hands of the enemy, and the enemy will batter you. And that will not be your portion, even as you surrender to him today. If you have not surrendered your life, the God Almighty will fight on your behalf in the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah. And so they came.